The descendants of Adam and Eve began to multiply and spread throughout the earth. However, men were corrupt and violent, just like Cain. God, witnessing the wickedness of men, regretted his decision. But there was a man known as Noah, who was fair and honest. Noah was walking the path of God. God then spoke to Noah and ordered him to build a large wooden ark. The great boat would have to be 135 meters long, 22 meters wide, and 13.5 meters tall. The ark would be split into different compartments and sealed with pitch. Then God told Noah that he would destroy all that existed on earth, and the creatures that live on it would also perish. God declared that he would summon a major flood, saving Noah and his family from it, forming an alliance with them. God ordered Noah to bring a couple of every living creature into the ark. The ark would also store food for the maintenance of the animals. Noah obeyed God's command. Therefore, two animals of every kind came to Noah and boarded his ark. The great flood promised by God began. 40 days and 40 nights of uninterrupted rain. The great ark floated on the waters, and even the great mountains submerged when confronted with such a massive torrent. All men and creatures who lived on earth perished. Only those in the ark survived. The waters covered the earth for 150 days straight. Only after that, the floodgates of heaven were closed, and the waters began to recede. Noah released a pigeon and a crow to see if they could find land, but they found nothing. Noah waited a few more days and released a dove, but this time the bird returned, carrying an olive branch in its beak, a sign that the earth was emerging again. The water would only return to its normal after a couple of days. Then God ordered Noah to abandon the ark and release all the animals that were inside it, and Noah did. The animals left the ark, and God made them fertile and multiply on the earth. Noah built a shrine dedicated to the Lord and offered a sacrifice to God. God was pleased with everything Noah had done and decided that he would never destroy again all the living creatures of the earth. Then God blessed Noah and his family, making them fertile, guaranteeing that they would multiply and populate the earth. God created the rainbow, the symbol of the pact between God and men. And from that day on, whenever Noah's descendants see a rainbow piercing the clouds, they recall the pact celebrated with God.